Now we're going to take a look at factoring trinomials in the form ax squared plus bx plus c when a is not equal to 1 and a is not a common factor. In this video we'll use the grouping technique to factor these types of problems. So the first step is to recognize that 4 cannot be factored out of this trinomial. So the first step in this process is to find the factors of a times c that add to b. So a times c would be 4 times negative 15, that's negative 60. We want the factors of negative 60 that add to negative 4. Well, negative 6 times 10 is equal to negative 60, but negative 6 plus 10 is equal to positive 4. We want a sum of negative 4. So if we switch these signs and use negative 10 and positive 6, that's equal to negative 60. And these two factors do have a sum of negative 4. So negative 10 and positive 6 are the factors that we want to use. So now what we're going to do is rewrite negative 4x as negative 10x plus 6x. So our polynomial with four terms will be 4x squared minus 10x plus 6x and then minus 15. Again, notice how we haven't changed the term, we just broke it up into a sum. Negative 4x is equal to negative 10x plus 6x. If you happen to write 6x minus 10x, it's not going to change the end result. But now that we have four terms, we'll factor this using the grouping technique. So we'll divide this in half, and then we'll factor the left and right side separately, hoping for a common binomial factor. So the greatest common factor between 4x squared and 10x would be 2x. So if we factor out 2x, we'd be left with 2x minus 5. And the greatest common factor of 6x and 15 would be 3, so we'll factor out a positive 3. And notice how we're left with 2x minus 5. And so we have this common binomial factor here, which we'll now factor out. So if we factor out the binomial factor of 2x minus 5, notice how we're left with 2x plus 3. Which is how we factor the trinomial 4x squared minus 4x minus 15 using the grouping technique. So you can see this process is a little bit lengthy, but if you like factor by grouping, it is a nice way to factor a trinomial when a doesn't equal 1. Let's try another one. Again, first step is to find the factors of a times c that have a sum of b. Well, a times c would be 20 times 3. So we want to find the factors of positive 60 that add to b, or positive 19. Well, that would be 15 times 4. This product is 60, and 15 plus 4 does equal 19. Now we're going to rewrite 19x as 15x plus 4x. So we'd have 20x squared plus 15x plus 4x plus 3. Now that we have four terms, we'll divide this in half and factor by grouping. The greatest common factor of 20x squared plus 15x would be 5x, leaving us with 4x plus 3. Notice how 4x and 3 don't have any common factors, but we could factor a 1 out, so we'll have plus 1 times the quantity 4x plus 3. Notice how now we have a common binomial factor, which we'll now factor out. And if we factor out 4x plus 3, notice how we're left with 5x plus 1. And now our trinomial is factored using the grouping technique. And we'll take a look at one more method for factoring these types of trinomials in the next video.